In this video, you will learn how to make one-way platforms that your player can jump on and drop through. One-way platforms are a common feature in side-scrolling games. Add extra depth and interest to your levels, making them look interesting and fun to play in. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor. Let's go ahead and get started. For us to be able to drop through platforms, we first need to be able to make a platform that will support our player on top, but will allow us to pass under it and jump through it. Luckily in Godot, this is as simple as setting the one-way collision variable in the collision shapes inspector. With this enabled, we can stand on top of the shape, but also pass through it from any other direction. You can also apply this setting to tile sets, to set the shape to be one-way before converting it into a tile set. Or select your tile map, and in the inspector, open up the tile set property. Find the tile that you want to make one-way, and inside of its properties will be a shape one-way variable that you can enable. There are a few things to note when using one-way collisions. The major one being that one-way slopes do not work properly in version 3.0. Often, your character will pass through them when climbing up the slope. From what I can tell, though, this seems to have been fixed in version 3.1, which is great because slopes really add a lot of interest to your levels. Now that we have one-way platforms, there's a little issue with our player controller if you've been following along with the platformer series. Since we're using raycast to determine if we're grounded, we get set as grounded as we jump up through the platform. You can see that Paul Bearer tries to switch to the idle animation as I jump up through the ground. To fix this, what we'll do is create a variable that will determine whether or not we're jumping or falling. There's no need for us to check if we're grounded when we're jumping because we can never land while jumping upward. So before we do our raycast for is grounded, we'll add an and condition to check if we're also not jumping. Since we're using an and condition, it will short circuit anything after it if it fails and set is grounded to false. To set our variable, we'll go to our input method, and after we perform our jumping logic, we'll set isJumping to true. And then to unset it, we'll go back to our physicsProcess method, and after we add gravity to our velocity, we'll make an if statement to check whether isJumping is true, and if our velocity.y is greater than or equal to 0. If so, then we are now falling and we'll need to set isJumping to false. With this, our little problem is fixed and we're ready to start dropping through platforms. The simplest way to do this, in my opinion, is to have our drop-through terrain and platforms be on the second bit of our physics collision layers. And when we want to drop through a platform, we'll just stop masking for that bit in our player's kinematic body and let gravity do the rest. For this tutorial, I want the player to drop through the platform whenever they jump while holding the down key. So we'll go to our project settings, and in the input map, we'll add a down action. I will set mine to the S key. Then, in our input method, after we check for jump input, we'll add another if condition and check input for isActionPressed down. This is different than the events method of the same name. When using the event, it checks to see if action was just pressed. With input, it checks to see if the action is currently being held. This is what allows the player to hold the down key and then press jump. If our drop-through condition is true, then we'll call the method setCollisionMaskBit. This is a nifty little method that Godot provides us with so that we don't have to deal with binary operators to modify the mask, which I was actually going to do with this tutorial until I recently found this alternative method. We'll be passing it 1 because that is the bit that we'll have our drop-through terrain on. But for readability's sake, I will create a constant named drop-through-bit and set it to 1. For the second parameter, we'll give it false, which is what sets the bit. And then, we'll add an else condition so that the player will jump as usual if they're not pressing the down key. However, you'll probably notice that we're doomed to never walk upon the surface of a platform again. To fix this, we're going to have to reset the collision mask bit. There are a couple ways of doing this. The best, in my opinion, is to add an area to the player. Move it down to the player's feet. Give it a rectangle shape 2D. And adjust its size so that its width is as wide as, if not wider than, the player's physics boundaries. Otherwise, the player could stand on the corner of a platform and never detect when it passes through it. And the top of the box will need to come up above the raycast for our ground checker. The idea for having this area is to tell us when it passes through a body, such as our platform. So we'll set the area's mask to the second bit and unset its layers. Then connect its body exited signal to our player script. And in the method for the signal, we'll make another call to set collision mask bit, giving it drop through bit, but setting it to true. And now we're blessed with the ability to once again tread the surface of the coveted drop through platforms. However, you'll soon notice that we have a familiar problem that has returned. Whenever we drop through a platform, our animation player tries to go back to the idle animation. This is because we are now falling through the platform, and our ground checkers are detecting the ground. Well, if we're falling through the ground, then we probably shouldn't be checking to see if we're grounded. We only want to check for this after we've passed through the platform. Thankfully, Godot provides us with yet another handy method called getCollisionMaskBit. We can use this to return a Boolean value based on if the mask bit is true or false. So back to our ground checking code. After our isJumping condition, we'll add another AND condition that will make a call to this method, passing a drop-through bit. This will fix our ground-checking problem for good. But there's another problem. If we try to drop through when we're standing on solid ground like our base tile map, then we stop checking for grounded and actually get stuck to the ground, because in this position, our area never passes through a drop-through platform, so it never resets the mask bit. To fix this, we need to check to see if we're standing on a drop-through platform or not, which we'll do with raycast. We already have raycast 2Ds which we're using to check if we're grounded, so we can just steal those. Duplicate them and rename the group node to drop-through raycast. Then change their collision mask to check for the second bit only. Back in our script, we need to check to see if any of these are colliding. We wrote a function for this in the previous video to handle our grounded raycast. We're going to hijack this by adding a parameter to this method named raycast, which will refer to the raycast that we're already using inside of this method. And I will default its value to self.raycast so that it continues to work where we called it earlier in our script. But now we can call this method and pass it the drop-through raycast node, and it will check those raycasts instead. Which we'll do this by creating a nested if statement in our input method. We nest it like this to prevent the player from jumping if they're holding down and jump, but they're standing on solid ground. Otherwise, they'll jump instead, which to me feels awkward. If you would like to learn more game development in Godot, then check out this video here. YouTube recommends it, and I probably would too. And if you're new, then be sure to join the sub club and ding-a-ling that bell to get notified for future videos. And until next time, y'all take it easy.